Wickedness is real. Oppression is real. But more real is our victory. For this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. God has commissioned Bishop David Oyedepo to preach the word of faith, liberating men everywhere from all oppressions of the devil. Get set for an empowerment that will enable you to rule in the midst of your enemies and subdue them under your feet. Now, Bishop David Oyedepo.
God's wisdom works, not just for this month, but as God has initiated you into that realm, into the higher realm of it, you keep living in that realm the remaining days of your life. God's wisdom creates solutions. When the earth was without form and void, God's wisdom stepped in and gave it shape and gave it color. At no point in your life will your life become colorless. The wisdom of God will help you to maintain His color in your life. You maintain His glorious shape in your family. You maintain His enviable color in your finances. So God's wisdom is our trade secret for an ever-winning life, because it creates solutions. It doesn't wait for it. It brings it to bear. It establishes it. You'll never be stranded again anymore in your life. Spirit of God, breathe upon us again this evening and let your word come true to every man's heart in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Exodus chapter 7 and verse 1. And the Lord said unto Moses, see, I have made thee a God unto Pharaoh, and Aaron thy brother shall be thy prophet. See, I have made you a God unto Pharaoh. See, come and see what I have made you. Now, when you are able to see what He has made you, no devil can unmake you. He said, see. The clearer you see what He has made you, the more unbeatable you become in the battles of life. He said, see, I have made thee. This was the secret of the confidence of Moses in the confrontation against Pharaoh. He had caught a clear vision of his new position. So there was nothing in Pharaoh that could scare him. I have made thee a God unto Pharaoh. See, you are in charge. It's no longer Pharaoh. See, whatever you say, Pharaoh has no choice but to shiver. Because even the devil believes that God is God, and when God moves, he shivers. That's why Moses could say to Pharaoh, Pharaoh, all protocols not observed. Pharaoh, let my people go. Not live long, O king. You die quick. O king, die quick. Pharaoh, he was calling him directly by his name, because somehow he has come to discover his place in God and has come to understand his superiority over Pharaoh. See, in Jeremiah chapter 1 and verse 11, he said, what seest thou? He said, I see a rod of an almond tree. He said, thou hast well seen, for I will hasten my word to perform it. When you see well, it hastens God's performance in your life. So the brighter you see, the faster the word comes through in your life. He said, see, I have made thee a God unto Pharaoh, and Aaron thy brother shall be thy prophet. It's very important as we talk about wisdom to see what God has packaged into us that qualifies us to operate in the realms of divine wisdom. When you are able to see that, you'll not be afraid to think. Many, many people in this part of the world are afraid to think. What will it weigh? What can I really think? And so we have become consumers, just like we are consumers of every good. We have become consumers of knowledge. We are not even confident to think. We are afraid of creating knowledge. We are afraid of initiating a new way of doing things. Because we have not been able to see what we are worth in God. It's very important for us to know that God made one man and made one woman, and out of these two came all the nations of men. So God has no races. I believe our pigmentation is a climatic condition. That's why you find the white man goes under the sun to blacken his skin. There is nothing about your outside man that affects your actual worth. God is no respecter of persons, but in every nation. So God sees every nation as one. It is human geography that makes them many. Every nation is made of every nation, one family. So I'd like you to please understand these basic things that qualifies you to operate in the realms of divine wisdom. And God is called the only wise God. Say with me, the only wise God. His wisdom has no comparison. That's why they call him the only wise God. He's not the wiser God. He's not the wisest God. He's the only wise God. In the realm of wisdom, he occupies his own unique realm. There is no comparing his wisdom on earth. There is not one person to compare his wisdom with. So they call him the only wise God. And what a joy that we are privileged by redemption to share that enormous virtue with them. Salvation makes you a child of God. And because like begets like, every offspring naturally carries the virtues of his source. So, the child of a dog possesses the virtues of a dog, including the wisdom of a dog. He won't need to learn how to bark. He was born with a barking nature. He barks. The child of a sheep is a sheep. He won't need to learn how about bleating. He begins bleating by nature. So you and I, by redemption, have become the children of God. And what that means is that we carry and possess the virtues inherent in God, including his wisdom. As many as believed him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God. So there was a change of position. We were sons of men before we met Jesus. And after meeting him, we became the sons and the daughters of God. So there's a change in lineage. Our root had changed. When we were born of our parents, we possessed the human wisdom naturally. You don't find a child that is born that tries to walk on four legs and they say, no, you are a man, you don't walk on four legs. No, naturally he walks on two legs. He walks on two legs. So when you and I became children of God, the same way we possess the natural virtues of our natural parents, we now qualify to possess the spiritual virtues or supernatural virtues of our supernatural God. That qualifies every redeemed soul to flow in the realm of divine wisdom. Can I hear your amen? Amen. We were human beings at birth. At new birth, we became spirit beings. For that which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the spirit is spirit. It's not spiritual, it's spirit. John chapter 3 verse 8 is spirit. And the Bible says God is a spirit. John 4:24, and all that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. So God is a spirit. And by regeneration, you became a spirit. So you share the same nature with God. And so you possess the same virtues as God. If God operates in the realm of unique wisdom, redemption qualifies you and I to operate in that realm. Can I hear your amen? Because God is a spirit and you are a spirit. John 3:8. The wind blows where it listeth, and you hear the sound thereof, but you can't tell where it's coming from or where it's... It says, so is everyone that is born of the Spirit. In John chapter 3, beginning from verse 5, that which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. So new birth qualifies you and me to become spirit beings. And because God is a spirit, we now possess the same virtues as God. Listen to this. No more must they ever refer to you as stupid in your life. In your workplace, they will soon start gathering around you to know what next to do. By reason of that nature, they marveled at his wisdom. At the age of 12, he is the first begotten of the Father. And the firstborn does not have any more access to the virtues of the parents than the lastborn. At the age of 12, they were astonished at his understanding. The nature of God was finding very loud expressions in his life. The same way from today, beginning from your own personal life, how you administer your life, your family life, your business life, the wisdom of God shall begin to find very loud expressions in your life. That's very important. Anyone that believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life. John 3:16. Eternal life. Now, before you met Christ, you possess human life. After your encounter in redemption, you now possess eternal life, the God order of life, the same life that God possesses. They call it Zoe in Greek. It is that same life that redemption conveyed to you and me. So we share the same nature with God. And subsequently, therefore, we possess the same potentials as God. Can I hear your loud amen? Amen. Because you possess his order of life, you carry his order of potentials. So whatever made God God in terms of wisdom is the same deposit that is already in you. Can I hear your loud amen? All I'm trying to do is to help paint your redemptive picture that will help you become conscious of what you carry. These are not theoretical issues. This is the truth. God is eternally the same, and his word is eternally true. It is our faith that determines our level of access to whatever he has spoken. And our faith is a function of our understanding of what has been provided for us. Please recognize that new birth does not make you a religious dogma, someone just living by some religious regulations. New birth empowers you to operate in the class of God because you possess the same nature as God. That means nothing around you is permitted to lose shape and color. Because when the earth was without form and void, God, by his wisdom, stepped in and gave it shape and gave it color. And that means no situation around you is permitted to lose shape anymore. Yeah. Nothing around you is permitted to lose color anymore. Yeah. In the name of Jesus Christ. We do not only just possess that nature. The Bible also records that we are heirs of God and joint heirs with Jesus Christ. Romans chapter 8 and verse 17. We are heirs of God and joint heirs with Jesus Christ. That means we share authority with God. We share authority with God. Now we have the queen who's still alive. He's refused to die. The queen is still having a nice time after many years. And then we have Charles, Prince Charles, the heir to the throne. He's sharing the same authority with the queen. Every time he visits any of their former colonies, they line up. The state government, everybody comes on the street, the soldiers, the police, everyone. He's just a prince. He's not a king. But he shares authority with the queen. So as an heir of God and a joint heir with Jesus Christ, you are by redemption empowered to share authority with God, to enjoy the dignity that God enjoys. And that includes your mental dignity. Can I hear your loudest amen? The Bible said we have been redeemed unto our God as priests and kings, and we shall reign on the earth. What does that mean? Why? Because you are an heir of God and a joint heir with Jesus Christ. You possess what enables a man to reign. The wisdom of God was imparted to you at birth. So you grew up to become an heir of God and a joint heir with Jesus Christ. You are what it takes to reign on earth, not to be ruined. You are what it takes to reign on this earth. Also, it's important for you to know that you are a citizen of heaven. A citizen of what? You are a citizen of heaven. Philippians chapter 3, verse 20. You are a citizen of heaven. Philippians 3, 20. Colossians chapter 1, verse 13. You have been translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of his own dear son. Ephesians 5 and 6, you have been raised up together with him and you are made to sit together with him in heavenly places. And Philippians 1, 20 and 21, that place is far above. So you are seated far above. You are seated how? Now in John 3, 31, the word of God says, whatever is from above is above all. So everything about everyone that is from above qualifies him to be above all. I'm glad to let you know tonight that in wisdom, you have been engraced to live above all. That is, nothing on earth should be able to match you in the manifestation of wisdom in your approach to every issue in life. Can I hear you shout a living amen? Amen. Say with me, I am from above. Therefore, I am above all. I am from above. Therefore, I am above all. I am from above. Now, you need these nuggets in order for you to actualize your redemptive position in Christ. You need to know that you share the same nature with God, and by so doing, you possess the same potentials as God. You need to know that you have eternal life, the God order of life. That means you have the same capability as God in the light of scriptures. You need to know that you are an heir of God, so you share authority with God. And as an heir of God, it is wisdom that entitles you to the throne. So the wisdom of God that entitles a man to the throne is inherent in you. Now see, this will free you from any form of intimidation. Say with me, intimidation. This will free you from any form and every form of intimidation. It will free you forever. It will free you forever. Until you are free to think, your destiny is not secured. It will free you forever. We are discussing today, there's a conference going on at Covenant University on the conference of innovations and innovators and inventors. And after the meeting, I was discussing with one of the people that spoke. And he said, you see, the problem is that the developed world removed the bridge that they used to cross from where they used to be and where they are now. He said, that's the problem we have. And I said, look, the bridge they used, did they borrow it? No, they created it. So our job is to create a bridge for ourselves to cross from where we are to where we should be. It's not anybody's problem. Then I said, when we were discussing, I said, Covenant University curriculum is not copied from America. It's not copied from Europe. By the ingenuity of the team of men, it was built and put together to suit and deliver the vision of the university. So you don't wait for somebody's bridge to cross over. You create your own bridge. Can I hear your loudest amen? You create your own bridge. Now the wisdom of God gives you the ability to think independently, think creatively, think innovatively, think inventively until your desire is delivered. Please understand that you have all it takes to make a mark on your generation. And start engaging that virtue that is inherent in you. Now, this is what positions you to actualize God's eternal plan for your life. Very important. Again, the word of God says that we are ambassadors of Christ. We are what? You don't put a dummy as an ambassador, do you? Now, you are talking about the kingdom of the only wise God. So, to deploy you as an ambassador, you must be sand. There is no quota system in this one. So, for God to see you and me fit for deployment as ambassadors, we have passed the wisdom test. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 20. How many ambassadors of Christ are here? Come on, let me see your hands. You should start taking ambassadorial steps. You start speaking ambassadorial words. You don't open your mouth just because everybody is talking. You talk only when you should talk. Because you possess kingdom diplomacy. You possess kingdom diplomatic capabilities. You don't just open your mouth. You speak only when it is necessary to speak. And you say only what is reasonable to say. And your speech is with objectivity. Now you see, you are ambassadors of Christ. What am I talking about? You are not only an heir of God to live in the palace and be going in and out. You are deployable to nations to represent the interests of that kingdom because you are deemed to possess the capability required. Is somebody saying amen to that? Ever since I caught wind of that word, I'm ambassador of Christ, I won't dress carelessly and I won't talk carelessly. I possess ambassadorial consciousness in the things I say. I hate to make guesses. I want to talk as frankly as possible on any issue that I have facts on. Please know that as an ambassador of Christ, heaven has cleared you to operate in the realm of divine wisdom. That means from today, no more error. Your dignity shall no longer be tampered with. Let me hear your loudest amen. You possess all it takes to represent the interest of the only wise kingdom under the only wise God. That means you are no ordinary brain. You are no ordinary brain. Ye are ambassadors of Christ. You are clad with divine immunities. You possess all that it takes to operate freely here. Until you see what he has made you, you really cannot fulfill your destiny to the fullest. What I'm saying here this evening is this: you have been equipped adequately to operate in the realm of divine wisdom. you have been adequately equipped to operate in the realms of divine wisdom. You have been adequately equipped to operate in the realm of divine wisdom. So every time you are surrounded, what do? He said, if any man lack wisdom because it's not permitted for you to operate otherwise, let him ask of God. When Daniel, Shadrach, and Abednego were surrounded, they said, give us time. Give us what? Give us time. We'll show you there is nothing here that we can't connect. What you have asked, there is no king of the earth who has ever asked that question. Neither are there any magicians who can give you the answer, but give us time. We'll make connections. And they went and prayed. Daniel 2, 16 to 19. And in the same night was the secret revealed unto Daniel. The remaining days of your life, you won't lack the secrets that will show you the way forward. In the same night was the secret revealed unto Daniel. The same night. The secret was revealed unto Daniel. The same night. Let's get back to source. The same night. I told you Julius Berger came here one time after we completed this building and started taking snapshots. What? And our own government won't look for genuine brains in Nigeria to engage. They must give it out to people outside because of personal interest. The whole of Canaan land is built by young Nigerians who have not corrupted their mind. Who knew what to do? Everything here. Not only that, members of this church family, there is no borrowed technology all through the length and breadth of Canaan land. It is Winner's family invented. Winner's family what? Invented. Shame to the devil. I said shame to the devil. It is the same ability for invention that God is imparting to you today. Years ago, we had a challenge in a construction program we had in Kaduna. And so we sent for UAC because we got to know that they had some technical expertise to help in spanning 54 meters, free span. So I spoke to the chairman that time, and the chairman said to me they would need to bring in their experts from Europe. Great. He will live in Sheraton Hotel in Lagos. What? He will come to Kaduna daily at our own expense. Great. He will take £500 as disturbance allowance for disturbing his life to come to Kaduna and come back. So I asked the question, does he have two heads? He said, what do you mean? I said, I mean exactly what I said. Does he have two heads? I said, we'll never need it. Thank you. Sure done. So I went back to site and I told the people, now, I was passing by the refinery, Kaduna refinery yesterday, I told them, because I was coming in from Makurdi, and I saw the enormity of the engineering feat of that site. And I knew that someone born of a mother, of a woman, was responsible for fixing it. He may not even be born again. I told the engineers, it would be a shame for you that an ordinary span will need a foreign expertise to fix. I said, get back to work or I do it by myself. Well, bless God, it's standing there today. No foreign expertise was engaged. And that gave us the confidence to now go 108 span. Haven't overcome that. This has become legendary in the school of engineering. Because someone dares it. Because they know that they possess what it takes. Those who do know their God and what he has made of them, they shall be strong and they shall do exploits. Stand to your feet. Shout hallelujah. You better believe it. Very shortly, the Nigerian dream car available to all Nigerians will come out of Covenant University. Why? Because the wisdom of the Creator is resident in us, and we are giving it room to express itself. I've said severally, if you can think enough, what you have is enough. The insufficiency we suffer in our financial management is traceable to insufficient reasoning. If you can think enough, what you have is enough. You'll be surprised that it is your planning error that leads to your financial horror. It's your planning error. It is your planning error that has led you to your financial horror. So innovation, invention is not just about machine. It's about intelligible programming of your life to deliver the shape you anticipate and get to where you are going. Why have we never borrowed? We have been able to manage whatever is made available to deliver what we should do. So we look at it. If this is going to cost this much, are there approaches you can undertake to cut the cost? And so we keep taking those approaches and cutting the cost. And God said, I'm so excited. I give you more money. I know you are managing it well. Now, to know that what you are earning is not the problem, but what you are planning. When you were earning 20,000, you were borrowing. It has increased to 50,000, you are still borrowing. It went to 70,000, your borrowing has enlarged. Now it increased to 100, and the borrowing has increased by 100%. Now it has grown to 200. It hasn't helped the borrowing spirit, because the poor planning that makes you a borrower has not been healed. Everybody's quiet. That's why we are taking communion here tonight, amen. Shout hallelujah. Why is it that the higher people go, the more indebted they become? Planning. Will you be surprised to know that money changes nothing? It is the quality of use to which you put money to that guarantees changes. So let's wake up and think straight. When I was earning 300 naira, I was not borrowing. Because there's a way to plan 300 naira to discipline your taste, to agree with your level where you are, and live your life free of charge. Amen? If I were eating what we were eating today, then I would have eaten up my future before it started. Has anybody ever asked you how much your shirt cost? In church, excuse me, how much is this shirt? No. You are the one who know why you have to buy it. You are the one who know what it's doing for your body. Each one buys the shirt that he can afford without being a burden. You can't wear a cloth on debt and not be wearing a weight. Particularly when you see the person you borrow from, the cloth becomes like iron on your neck, isn't it? And again, say you are blessed. You did as if you didn't hear, because the money to pay is not there. Particularly if you have promised him that last Sunday you will give him. This Sunday you change from Hope Entrance. And this church is very large. They can't find you. Amen. Hallelujah. Now there are members of your church who will never know they are members of this church till you die. Why? This is your own permanent arm. That's his own permanent arm. And they are all different churches. This is a different church, isn't it? This is a different church. And this one is a different church. This one is upper church. I mean, so if you offend somebody here, you can run to this other wing. You don't even stay on the ground floor, you go up. No matter how hard the place, it can't find you. Amen. Lift up your two hands. Lord, give me grace to allow your wisdom find expression in my life. Loud expression in my family, in the management of my finances, in my budgeting. I need your wisdom. Come on now, pray. Pray, pray, pray in the name of Jesus Christ. You have equipped me to operate in the realm of divine wisdom. Now enable me to give it expression. In my daily planning, in my daily programming, enable me, Lord, to give it expression. Enable me, Lord, to give it expression. Receive a fresh baptism of that spirit tonight. Receive a fresh release of the spirit of wisdom tonight. Receive it now. Oh, Jesus. I have what it takes to give my life shape and give it color. To give my finances shape and give it color. To give my head shape and give it color. I have all it takes. So help me, Jesus. Come on now, pray. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. By this communion tonight, receive a fresh inoculation of the virtue of divine wisdom. In the name of Jesus. Whatever step you have taken that is generating pressure on your life, any aspect of your life, your family life, your finances, your business, your career, your health, wisdom to retrace your steps for the best of results, receive it now in the name of Jesus. Whatever area of your life is losing color and losing shape, by the virtue being transmitted through the communion mystery tonight, wisdom to restore the shape and the color, receive it now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Remember, they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like the eagles. So look forward to the renewal of strength, the renewal of your mind, the renewal of your intellect, the opening up of the channel of divine wisdom. Lift up those hands and require that from the Lord right now, and it shall be yours for a possession. In Jesus' precious name. Lord God, we approach this table tonight and we look forward to all of the benefits that is back of this mystery. Let it be, Lord, in Jesus' precious name. Let no afflicted return with the affliction tonight. Let every desire be delivered for a testimony. Lord, I pray that you will open the channel of divine wisdom afresh into every life. That as we partake of your blood and of your flesh, let your nature begin to find loud expressions in our lives. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Lift up those two hands to heaven. Worship His Majesty. Celebrate Him. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Your strength is renewed, body, soul, and spirit. It's a new day and a new dawn for everyone. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are covered by the blood in your going out and in your coming in. In the name of Jesus Christ, all that has been passed on to you tonight remains a spiritual asset the remaining days of your life in the name of Jesus. So shall it be. In Jesus' precious name. Lift up those two hands and let's share the goodness in fellowship, everybody. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever. Amen. Peace. Congratulate your neighbors to your right and to your left. Jesus is Lord.
Bishop David Oyedepo has just placed in your hands the key to all-round victory, exploits, success, and unquestionable dominion over all life's challenges. The end has come to all your struggles in Jesus' name. Please share your testimony with us. Write Bishop David Oyedepo, 21688 Ikeja, Lagos, Nigeria. Or call 817-9670, 817-9671, 817-9672, 817-9673, and 817-9674. Or send your testimony through the email bishop@winnerskinandland.org. And best of all, come hear the man of God live as you worship with us at Faith Tabernacle, Kinanland, Kilometer 10, Idiroko Road, Ota. On Wednesday, 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. On Sundays, 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. God bless you.